a lot of beginning pain was 208, 209. You know, last 2 months at the end of my first career, 17 years, I decided it's time to change, right? So it's time to move on, and I spent a month, last month and a month after I left, painting about 20-30 pieces like this, 18 to 24 inches. It's kind of like beginning pieces, right? All very early work. Some parts work, like the violin, but you see some of the faces are a little bit tentative. Paintings are a little bit tentative here, but some of the colors are quite, you know, bright and striking, right? If you look at this, some of the textures are good, but some of the colors are messed up. But you know, it's what I call my initial start to painting, and it's just a student quality or student grade work. But so this is stuff that I kept for that, you know, from that era.
Satu tersemat di kalbu, pasti terubat rindu di hati.
And then yeah, I took 2 years break from art. You see all these pieces that should have been. I was too busy climbing the corporate ladder, so couldn't do art in peace, right? So 2 years of no art, just like self-taught. I have 300 or 400 books on art, and I got a big stack of DVDs. And I do a lot of training. So, although I don't take formal lessons, I learn a lot from a lot of the gurus I know. And I spend time like Frank Webb, Cheng Kichi, and so on. And a lot of the artists with their DVDs. Okay, so these two pieces, yeah. This is probably around March 2012. This is about October 2011. So 6 months apart. When I started painting, I like bright colors, very, very bright. Bright to the extent that even the backgrounds are bright. And then, you know, as I progress, it becomes a little bit more mature, the color and selection. More, slightly more real in the color. This is less real, more bright. I actually like this better. I want to come back to this. But today, I'm painting very much like this. I'm not coming back to this. Virgin washes decorated with calligraphy. So the way I do this is that I have a blank piece of paper, I have an idea what I want to paint, I have all my paints all pre-mixed, I have my brushes all loaded with water and ready to go. I drink some coffee and, you know, all set, like fencing, right? And then I go at it like in 20 minutes, right? When I'm done, I look at it and say, did it work? If it doesn't work, I shred it and I start again. So this is calligraphy on acrylic. Sometimes a piece like this is nothing but just yellow or orange and an excuse to put color on the canvas. This is what it is. You take a step back, it's like a flower, but really it's more an excuse to put the color on the canvas. That's basically that, right? Terkapar-kapar. Searching, my daughters and I, we play a lot on Saturday morning. I'll ask her, do you want to go to zoo? Can you paint? Oh, okay, we can paint. So, zoo, bird park, or painting. So it's a workshop with daddy. So sometimes she will draw and paint like this. I will sort of teach her about contrast of color, orange and blue. I'll ask her, what is the contrast of orange? Yeah, blue. And, you know, so blue goes on, right? And sometimes I have to help her improve her painting. So daddy's influence. Sometimes she will draw and paint, and I'll mix the colors for her and she'll paint. Sometimes she'll say, daddy, can you draw me an angel? So I'll draw an angel. a whole sort of a workshop with Danny and her friends, all her batik and from her school. Her school and her friends in school. Yeah. Everything that God's animal really is just amazing, right? Solomon in all glory, Jesus is, you know, can't even beat the simple lilies of the field. So you look at all the flowers, they are all sort of a little meditation or edgework of the Almighty in some ways. This one, I'm very proud of it because I've managed to sort of capture the dark. A sure sign of a beginner's watercolor is when you cannot do dark. Dark is very difficult in watercolor. A lot of my watercolor are like beginners because they can't do dark. So this is one of my latest, like April this year. And you could see the design element as well. This is intentional, it wasn't in my photograph this piece here. So I point it to the center where the focus is, and all the dark shape move your eyes to the flower. So the composition is actually very strong. And you know, quite a lot of people wanted this, and I'm sure this can be on fire.
So as I said, the hallmark of a good watercolorist is being able to do dark. But I could do
learn something new. It's like a trick. You put it in your bank, you move on to the next one. So you see more calligraphy on washes. This one doesn't quite work because I was trying to create dark around the flower. And this dark, because it's an earlier one like January or something around that time, didn't quite turn out as dark as that. Because I didn't know the technique. Now I don't. Then I did. So this sort of my head. Okay, this piece here is out of an exercise room.
Takkan ku hirau, asalkan sampai tempat.